あいつはそもそも高校になんて通ってねえよ。
I rest my chin on my hand as he gazes vacantly out of the window. Where did I come from? Where am I going? Where did Kadai Joe come from? Where did he go? Those philosophical questions were supposed to be the only things to occupy my mind, but without realizing it, I've ended up consumed with thoughts of a certain girl instead. Ohara Rinne. That's a good picture. The girl who saved me, and the one I now have to save. Wait, what was I thinking about again? The pattern on her panties? No, I'm sure it wasn't that. Dude, what the? God damn it. Be serious, Setsuna. Can't seem to think clearly right now. It's as though I've just woken up from a dream, the images in my mind melting away like snow in the sun. Summer heat is obviously frying my brain. That humid sea breeze must be getting to me. Either way, the season is turning me crazy. When winter comes around, yeah. Should be able to remember everything then. Or maybe. Ellipses. If only we had air conditioning. I have no complaints about the room itself, but the lack of AC is a major drawback. It's pretty tough for a weakling like me. Maybe Rinne would install one for me. If I asked. Rinne. Once again, she's the first thing on my mind. I'm really bothered by what Karin said when she left. I don't know enough about Rinne. All I know is her name and her age. So maybe that is enough. After all, I don't even know my own name and age. Ellipses. Come on, stop it. You're just going around in circles now. I try to force myself away from the window, but then... Right beneath my window, I spot a distinctive white hat disappearing into the mangrove forest. Oh yeah, her daily routine. Ellipses. She looks a little unsteady on her feet for some reason. Maybe my eyes are deceiving me. All the same, she needs to be careful. Ooh, it's a nice crunchy, like... I'm walking on sand sound effect. The crunching of sand on a foot is a tremendously satisfying sound. Yeah, I was gonna say, it's very nice. She must have heard it too, because she turns around and addresses me.
Stalker, 発見?
Sounds happy. Maybe she's been waiting for me. A little smile of hers almost leads me to believe so. The 2 days I spent with her are enough to tell me that isn't the case. However blunt she can be normally, coming here always seems to put her in a strangely good mood. At night, this beach is Rina's realm. That's why I was hesitant to talk to her. This place is given form by the sound of the waves, with Rina's own clear voice. Felt like I'd completely ruined the atmosphere if I opened my mouth. So I suppose it's too late now. I've already invaded her sacred ground. I did so the moment I woke up here yesterday. It's dangerous to walk around by yourself at night. Just think of me as your bodyguard.
You've
just been lucky up until now. Or maybe I'm the one who's lucky. I'm glad I woke up here, of all places, here on her sacred ground. I'm glad she found me during one of her daily walks. She hadn't, I wouldn't be able to talk to her like this right now. It really has been just a series of coincidences. A bad feeling comes over me for a brief moment. I'm only here as a result of a series of coincidences. If anything had deviated from its course, everything would have turned out completely different. It makes me realize just how valuable this present moment is. Does the reason I'm alive lie here in this present as well? Dragged back to reality, I look up. Rinne has begun walking along the beach, her hands behind her back. I hurriedly followed after her.
Setsuna wa unmei tte shinjiteru?
Fate or destiny? Destiny. It's a word that most girls seem to like. The idea is that some higher power exists in this world, leading us all on a predetermined path. A world, a future, mapped out to perfection. How ridiculous. People are able to change a future. In fact, we have to. If there really is such a thing as destiny, then I'll do what I can to tear it apart. I I inadvertently come to a halt. Her words are too frightening, or too freighted with meaning for me to just ignore them. What is it that I'm trying to save? There really is such a thing as destiny, then maybe it is Rinne. Maybe I met her because destiny led me to this place. In order to set her free from her apparent destiny. Ellipses. In that case, there's something I need to ask. How long have these walks been part of your daily routine? For a moment, her eyes waver. Seems to grasp what it would mean to answer my question. Karan told me very clearly that Rinne doesn't go to school. I highly doubt she's in college already. She's 17. I don't think this little island even has a college. In other words, there's only one possible answer. I thought she was able to keep up such a self-indulgent lifestyle because she was a student on summer vacation. I thought it was something temporary, a brief deviation from her usual routine. But I was wrong. You don't go to school? I mean, my parents forced me to, man. Just saying. Ellipses. Then, to be fair, man, I found ways to shorten my in-classroom time in some ways, but then I ended up actually extending it way too much in other ways. No, sorry for asking something so strange. It's not like high school is compulsory. It's up to you whether you go or not. Though I got the feeling that this issue holds a key to saving her. She lets out a huge yawn, making no effort to stifle it. Hmm? I thought you were a night owl. That's great. She takes this opportunity to get your sleeping pattern back to normal. She looks at me reproachfully. I don't sense any genuine anger from her, though. It's destiny, so you better come to terms with it. But even if everything is preordained, I'll change that destiny bit by bit. That way I'm sure that I'll be able to save her. Rinne? Rinne? Hey, Rinne. Rinne lets out a small gasp and looks at me drowsily. She instantly closes the novel she was reading, now being impossible to tell where she got to. The sour look on her face, she returns the book to the pile in front of her. Why don't you go to bed if you're that sleepy? How did things turn out like this? I thought she was finally going to make an attempt to reverse her sleep cycle, but I couldn't have been more wrong. Said she'd stay up all night reading, and wouldn't listen to a thing I said. I couldn't exactly leave her alone either, so I end up staying here with her. Well, I don't particularly mind, but... I stifle a giant yawn. I think I picked the wrong book to read. The Lost World by Michael Crichton. It's so long and torturous, and there are too many parts I just don't get. To be honest, it doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever. Wait, this is a sequel. Well, that explains it. Hey, Rinne, do you have the volume that comes before this?
これね、はい。
2001 A Space Odyssey by Arthur C. Clarke. It's a completely different author. How do you go from a space epic to a story about a single island, anyway? If you're trying to reduce the scope of the story, isn't that kind of over the top? You have so many difficult books, though, don't you? A big pile of books on the desk, both Japanese and foreign. And not just novels, I also spot some biographies and history books. Living all the way out here, it must have been hard work building up this kind of collection. Dude, I don't want to talk about the number of books I've lost throughout the years because of wear and tear and damage and just because I moved around a lot. I had books that were given to me as gifts, like when I was in like grade school, like elementary school, like when I was like in like fifth or sixth grade, that have fallen apart because of time. It's just really sad, man. And you have to build up that collection again. I'm, like, Like, in the place I live now, I've been living here for a year, and I lost a ton of books in, like, my move between the place I lived prior to this, two times prior to this, and the place I live now, because I live in a bigger house now than I did before when I was rooming with Meth, who was my roommate, my previous place. But before then, I had, like, all my books and stuff stored at my parents' place, but my parents had to, like, move. And so they were in storage for like a few years, and I finally was able to, I now have the space, like, take them out of storage and I organize them. I'm missing, like, I think, like, 100 plus, like, volumes of manga. I'm missing, like, all my old, like, history books, textbooks, etc. that I, like, not, like, ones I used for school, but ones I actually collected for, like, my own personal reading. It's really sad, actually. Oh, I lost my old encyclopedia collection, but that wasn't as, like, bad. It was like the first encyclopedia collection I was able to buy. I bought it for like $30 at a garage sale, and that was nice because I leafed through that all the time. But that was like a growing up thing. You can find a ton of that kind of like research resource like online now, so I don't mind as much. But like, definitely other things I miss. Then maybe I'll be able to find the first volume there. I'll go and have a look. It just doesn't feel right to start in the middle of the story. I mean, that's what it feels like for us, because we had amnesia and we were just like, oh, here we are on an island. Every story has a beginning and an end. There's no point reading only the middle section. I bet this library is going to be super, like, important. Maybe Rinne was starting to get bored too. Despite her exasperated sighs, I can tell from her expression that she's actually quite pleased to have something to do. Holy. This is amazing. I feel compelled to give voice to my genuine astonishment. The room's not too large, but it's a real maze of bookshelves. There are a few narrow aisles, but they're scarcely wide enough for one person to pass through. The shelves are lined with books of all sizes. There are even stacks of them on the floor. Maybe they didn't fit on the shelves, or maybe they just still need to be categorized. With this many books, you could probably open your own lending library. The only flaw would be the fact that it's so musty in here. She's already read everything in here? Is she a machine? It was, huh? Where's your dad now? I feel like I need to ask. A father, a mother, and a kid or two. It's a classic nuclear family. We've never seen any trace of our father's presence in this house. Suppose this library must be something of a reminder of him, in that case. The empty spaces on the shelves must be from books that Rinne has taken upstairs to read. A vast book collection left behind by her father. Rinne obviously just nibbles away at it. To pass her time here in the mansion instead of going to school. The knowledge you can glean from books is different from real-world experience, though. Books are just records of the past. They don't contain anything of the present. I agree with the sentiment of, like, being surrounded by books also is, like, has a very calming effect. Like, for me personally as well, I don't like it that it's like a relic of the past though that she's stuck in. Like, there's something like when I surround myself books, like going to a bookstore, like, or like, you know, going, like, you know, like reading next to my manga collection, it's to like just get fully immersed in the world of the book and to enjoy it for what it is. But I feel like they're representing Venus like plight here as like she's stuck in it, almost. Like she's stuck in it, and she's accepting it and has come to terms with it, kind of thing. It's not feel like she engrosses herself in the books just because she enjoys reading a lot. Because that's what I do. Like, I've enjoyed reading since I was a little child, and it's just something that, like, I fell out of and came back into in more recent years again. Hence why it was when I moved to my current place, I actually got all my old books and I set them up and stuff again, a lot of them anyway. But like, for this, it's like I think they're trying to portray this image of, like, she's stuck in the past. Or, like, stuck in time kind of thing. If you want to go more towards, like, there's time travel and stuff, like, route. Which we don't know anything much more about than what Sara has said, really. And the very little what Setsuna has, like, gleaned. Rinne looks unusually lively as she slowly walks the aisles of the library, reminiscing about the past. I wonder if lively is really the right word, though. Maybe time is standing still for her, just like it is in this dusty library. Oopsies. A chill creeps up my spine. It feels like my heart is freezing over. You should go to bed. It's better that you sleep at night and wake up in the morning. It's how you make it through the cold of the night, with the warm morning sun there to greet you when you wake. That's how we humans move forward. That's how we make progress. Otherwise, you just end up like me. Logically speaking, she's not wrong. But I don't think she's exactly right either. I'm not sure how to put it into words, but that's how it looks to me anyway. It's the concept of time that really bothers me here. Time passes at the same rate for everyone. Yet some of us are always pressed for time, while others have too much of it on their hands. That's why people are constantly struggling to use their time effectively. I feel that, man. Time isn't the sort of thing you should set out to kill. She flashed me a wonderfully innocent smile. Maybe this is good enough for now. But I can't guarantee that I'll be here forever. Because there's something I have to do. Ellipses. What will happen to Rinne when the time comes? Will she go back to being a lonely little princess? No, she's not the one I should be worrying about. Will I be able to leave her behind? You got me there. I'm not in any position to tell people what they should and shouldn't do. I don't even know what I have to do myself. I can't do anything for her as long as I'm still hesitating. If you want to change somebody else, you first need to change yourself. You first need to know yourself. I'm sorry for trying to lecture you. I know I'm just a servant. I won't complain about your lifestyle choices anymore. She lets out a yawn so big that I feel like she might suck me in as well. So you're taking my advice after all. Don't tell me that you just want to win the arm again. Rina's yawning reminds me just how sleepy I am myself. The only reason I stayed up reading was to keep Rinne company. Alright, I'll head up too then. I'm about to follow after Rinne and leave the library when... A soft sound at my feet stops me in my tracks. Whoops, I kicked the book off one of the piles. This book? Reach down and pick it up. Urushima, The Truth Behind the Legends. While the title piques my curiosity, the name of the author sticks out even more. Ohara Norimasa? The plain manuscript doesn't even have a cover.
Ah, sore ne. Otousan ga kaita hon yo.
Your dad was a writer.
Minzoku gakusha. Jishou da kedo ne.
Still pretty amazing that he published a book.
Ippan ni demawatteru hon ja nai wa. Jibun de seihon shite ta kurai da mono.
I see. Not to be rude, but that explains why the binding looks so cheap. After swiping away some dust, I flip through the pages. That's such a waste. Skimming the pages, I can see that it's obviously all about this island. Aside from the text, there are illustrations and photographs mixed in throughout. One image in particular captures my attention. It shows a woman dressed all in black holding up a snake. Looks almost like a religious icon. There's a signature in the lower right corner reading Ohara Norimasa, so I assume he drew it himself. To say that he merely called himself a folklorist seems like an understatement. Even as a layman, It's obvious that a work as detailed as this must have taken a lifetime to compile. Hmm? There's a piece of paper stuck between the last two pages. It's folded neatly in half. I open it quite blithely. It's a threat directed at me. I crumble the sheet of paper up into a ball. Don't worry, it's nothing. Ellipses. What kind of prank is this? Who's behind it? Rinne? No. She wouldn't have had any chance to put this here. Even if she had, why would she? Rinne, when did your dad pass away exactly? The moment I opened my mouth, I noticed a colophon at the back of the book. Publication year is listed as 1989, 10 years ago.
What? Nani?
Never mind, it's nothing. Well, yeah, because this is obviously weird. It doesn't matter when the book was published. It's strange that my name should be written there in the first place. After all, I came here from the future and I only arrived yesterday. Yeah, let's go. Who could have scribbled this note and when? Huh. However much I think about it, I can't seem to figure it out. Take another close look at the piece of paper. Setsuna must die. There's no doubting what it says. Because it's written in English for us. If it isn't a prank, then could it be a message? But even if it were, I came across it by sheer coincidence. Happy to go down to the library, kick that exact book entirely by accident, and then pick it up without thinking. There's no way that anyone could have predicted all that. It's impossible no matter which way you look at it. Ellipses. No, not necessarily. What if there was no need to predict that chain of events? I swear I'll kill Setsuna. That's what the man in my dream this morning said. If the dream was an actual memory of mine, then I must surely have come here to kill a man named Setsuna. That. But let him go free to do as he pleases. Some sort of tremendous disaster is certain to befall the world. Ellipses. I don't think that was just a dream. It must have been a fragment of my memories I've lost, a part of my past, this world's future. I'm on a mission to kill a man named Setsuna. Ellipses. Having traveled back to this era, though, I've lost all my memories. Maybe things are just programmed that way, like that girl, Garandasara suggested earlier, today. Maybe I'm not supposed to bring any information from the future back to the past. I can't fulfill my mission that way. I need to be able to remember my mission without influencing the past in any other way. That must be why I received this message. I picked up that book out of sheer coincidence, but from the perspective of someone in the future, that coincidence would be bound to happen. All they had to do was put a message in that book in such a way that I'd be the only one to see it. And then I found it and remembered my mission, just as they planned. Ellipses. The only question is, who is this Setsuna that I'm supposed to kill? Logically speaking, they would have to be someone living this era, someone who will one day bring disaster upon the world. This is a peaceful age, though. Is it really possible that one person could have such an outsize influence on the fate of the world? I don't think so. Unless it's Setsuna is no ordinary human being. Ellipses. I accidentally mentioned the name of the person I'm supposed to kill to Rinne. In other words, I provided her with a piece of information from the future. That moment a time paradox was created. That one little word has started warping the course of history. A chain of cause and effect has twisted in on itself like a Mobius strip. At this rate, I'll end up bringing about the paradox to end all paradoxes. And somebody from the future is going to come back to the past to kill me and restore the natural course of history. Get what's going on now. Ellipses. At this point, it's meaningless to worry about which is cause and which effect. Figuring out the truth is more important. Damn it, this is all so confusing. I am the Setsuna. My mission was to kill myself. Stare at my reflection in the window and a man whose name I don't know stares back at me. A man whose mission is to save the world took him back into the past. A man whose resolve must have been strong enough even for him to risk his own life. And now he's found his target. Time for him to carry out his mission. Ooh. Oh, what the heck is going on? Ooh, we have a... this is an interesting choice. Carry out your mission, abort your mission. I mean... If it means to save the world, you gotta carry out your mission. I'm just saying. What if I hadn't mentioned that name to the girl in the hat? What if I lost my memories entirely? What if I hadn't been able to recall this mission I imposed on myself? Maybe I'd have been able to carve out an ordinary, undistinguished life here for myself. Maybe I'd have saved the world by complete accident that way. Nobody else would have ever learned the truth. Ellipses. It's too late to consider any alternatives now. I've already brought a paradox in this world. So only one way to stop myself from messing things up even further. I address the man reflecting in the window. I'm going to kill you. I wander around the island searching for a suitable place to fulfill my mission. I end up walking to the point of a cape beyond a sign reading no entry. The ocean waves break on the rocks at the bottom of the near vertical cliff beneath me. So it should be high enough. I don't feel the slightest fear. The pain of it will last only a fleeting moment after all. And most importantly, my actions here will save the world. However, I'm left with one regret. The fact that, in my short time on the island, I managed to get myself acquainted with those girls. Though notice that I've gone missing. I wonder what the ever carefree Princess Rinne will look like when she finds out. What will the little shrine maiden, servant of the gods, think when she realized I chose to take my own life? How will that high school girl, still desperate to get to the mainland, react when she finds out that I can't fulfill my promise to her anymore? I'm so sorry, everyone. But I have a mission to carry out. There's something I have to do in order to protect this world. Besides, this doesn't mean the end for me. One day I'll be born into this world. Maybe I've already been born somewhere. I'm happily living my life, wholly unaware of what's going on here. I'm sure that I'll be able to keep on living alongside everyone else. In the new world that'll be created when I erase this paradox. This isn't the end, it's the beginning. A new start for my true self. Let's meet again sometime. Take a big step forward towards a bright future. Ending. A new world. My true self.
Okay. Island.
Well, we got an ending. What the...